Welcome. In this video I'm going to show you how you can determine Cohen's DS for a independent samples t-test using SPSS. I'll be using SPSS version 25 for this, but it should also work in previous versions. Unfortunately, actually, SPSS cannot calculate this straight away from the graphical user interface, so we'll be using the output and then an online calculator. And I'll also show you how you can do it if you really want with SPSS syntax. The easiest would probably be to simply use an online calculator. And for that, I first need some output from an independent samples t-test. I'm going to be using grades for that, which was up here. What grade would you give? And your gender, female or male, were the only two options in this survey, and as the categories. So the independent samples t-test can be done by going to analyze and then compare means, and then select independent samples t-test. I have a separate video on this, so I won't go into too many details. And I need the gender and the groups. Right click, variable information were 1 and 2, so define groups 1 and 2, and I need the grade, and click on OK. Now this table up here actually gives me all the information that I need. There are other ways to get such a table, but I think this is pretty straightforward. I'll make it slightly smaller because now we can use this information and go to a website. So let me open up my Chrome there for you and go to peterstatistics.com. And on there, that's my personal website, go for two variables unpaired and then select the binary versus scale. Then on the left, it's about effect sizes, so click on that. And underneath this table, it will probably say something like click here to see how to do this with SPSS, etc. And one of the options would be online calculator. And here we can then enter that information that we had. So we need the number of cases and the number and the means. So I'm going to try to make this a little bit easier. Best way to do this, it's 11 and 30. So I can just type those in, 11 and then 30. Then the means in the same order. So that's these two. Now, if you find two decimals enough, okay. But if you double click and then double click again, it actually shows you far more decimals. So you can use that, copy paste. Here the same thing, copy paste. And the standard deviations, be careful, it's not the standard error, but the standard deviation. And click and copy and paste. And there we have it, Cohen's D is about 0.28. So that's how you can quickly determine Cohen's D using SPSS output. Now, another way of doing this is actually by using some syntax. If you go to the IBM website, which actually owns SPSS, someone actually posted this questions before Cohen's D, and it actually finally shows that none of these will produce a D. So one way around that is to use what is known as syntax, that's up here, and I'll leave a link to this website as well in the description below. And what we can do is copy this, right click and copy, and then go back to SPSS, and we need some syntax, so file and then new and syntax. That will open up up here in this window. We paste the result, and as you can see, I'm getting an error because mean here is actually not allowed. So I'm going to add a little a up here, mean a, and the same for SD, and then a, and then n, and then a. And we need to do also here the same things, and n, a. And now if we run all of this, it should actually give us the same result, hopefully. And let's see, did we get any output? And there it is. We have the 0.28225332237, which was indeed the same as on my online calculator. That was up here. So you can see that those two actually nicely match each other, so they're doing the same thing. There is a bit of an interpretation, Cohen's D here also on the website, that's from Cohen himself, but those are always rules of thumb, so don't take these too seriously. There are other rules of thumbs out there, but hopefully they still help. Okay, that was it. Thank you for watching, hope you enjoyed this. If so, please subscribe because that really helps out.